Next, we are going to learn about the third theory called electromagnetic wave theory of light. Here, we had seen that some of the drawbacks were seen in the case of wave theory. That one was overcome in the next theory. What are the drawbacks? We have to recall them. He introduced a new kind of hypothetical medium called Huygens. He introduced a new kind of hypothetical medium called ether to explain the propagation of the light through the vacuum. He told that ether was pervaded everywhere, even in the case of atmosphere of the earth and also in the vacuum region between the earth and the sun. Everywhere light is able to propagate through the ether medium. Such kind of explanation was explained by whom? Huygens. Later, the existence of the ether was disproved by the next theory called electromagnetic wave theory. Okay. So here, this new theory was introduced by James Clerk Maxwell. As per James Clerk Maxwell's idea, light is not a mechanical wave. First, you have to understand that he told that light is not a mechanical wave. If light is a mechanical wave, definitely it requires some material medium. So he insisted that, he explained that light should not be in the form of mechanical wave. So to avoid the confusion related to the ether, he removed the idea from the mind of the scientist that light is not a mechanical wave. And then he introduced a new kind of theory called electromagnetic wave theory. This electromagnetic wave theory was already explained in the chapter 5. Already we have learnt about electromagnetic wave theory in the chapter 5 in a very elaborate manner. Again, I would like to recall, he introduced a new kind of wave called electromagnetic waves. As per the electromagnetic wave, light travels in this format. How? The light, it travels, its propagation that takes place both in electric field as well as in magnetic field. Here two vectors are there, electric vector and magnetic vector, two vectors are there. This light, it possesses two vectorial formats. Are you clear? So here, that light, when it travels in the form of electric field vector and magnetic field vector, both are perpendicular to each other, and in the meantime, the light propagates in this direction, that is along the direction. In this direction means this one could be taken as Z, and the electric vector can be taken as X axis, and the magnetic vector direction can be taken as Y axis. So electric vector, magnetic vector, direction of propagation of the wave, all the three, they are mutually perpendicular to each other. So in this form, that light travels. Okay, this kind of idea was proposed by whom? James Clerk Maxwell. So now we have to forget that the light travels in the form of mechanical wave. After the introduction of electromagnetic wave theory, simply you have to forget the light nature as mechanical wave. Now, as per James Clerk Maxwell theory, we have to understand that light travels in the form of electromagnetic wave. And he insisted one more point, that the electromagnetic wave, they need not require any material medium. So without any material medium, electromagnetic wave, they are capable of traveling even through vacuum. Are you clear? Without any material medium, light is able to travel even through vacuum. And as per the Huygens theory, Huygens, he told that the light travels in the form of longitudinal wave. But later, that idea was disproved, and the scientists, they have proved that light travels in the form of transverse in nature. So now you combine both. Light travels in the form of electromagnetic wave. That electromagnetic wave, it is in which form? That electromagnetic wave, that is traveling in the form of transverse waves in nature. Okay. So light is a combination of both the two properties. It is an electromagnetic wave. In the meantime, it is traveling in the form of transverse waves. Don't forget, these two combination is very important. So no metal medium is required for the propagation of the light. By using this theory, all phenomena of light were able to be explained. All phenomenon means reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction. These four properties were clearly explained, successfully explained by using which theory? Electromagnetic wave theory. But these two effects were not able to be explained by electromagnetic wave theory, which two effect? Photoelectric effect and Compton effect. Compton effect is a kind of scattering effect. Photoelectric effect, you are going to learn the concept in atomic physics and nuclear physics concept, and also in dual nature. There you are going to learn about the photoelectric effect in a very detailed manner. So here, we could explain this photoelectric effect with the help of the next theory. So these two effects were not able to be explained by electromagnetic wave theory. So I have summarized all the important points related to electromagnetic wave theory. Okay.